community of partnership, unity and spirit of society, and then in front of what our holiday. Usually after the three important days, the Mrs. Peccatis Vestris, the Ruka Vos, a Vita Meterna, Indulgencia, Absolution, and the Mission of Peccatorum Ostrorum, the Boa Noris, some important, and the Recourse Dominus. Deus to converse us with the Carismas, Ostend in Omnis Domine, Misericordiam Tuam, Domine Exalti Ratio Mea, Dominus Fodis Tuum,
Qui vides et regnas cum Deo Patre et unitate
absit gloriae, insigni cruce Domini nostri Gesù Christi. Per quem mihi mundus crucifixus est, et ego mundo. In Christo e in Gesù, neque circuncisio alimpibaret, neque precuncion et sed nova creatora. Epicumque quam regulam sequuti fueri, pax super illos, et misericordia et super visquae adegi. De cintoro nemo mihi molestusi, e vomini stigmata nomini nostri, Domini Jesu, in corpore meo porto. Grazie Domini nostri Jesu Christi, cum spiritu destro fratres. Amen. Os justi, meditabitur sapientia, et lingua eius docetur judici, lex te eius in corde ipsius, et non sumant ab multa gressus eius. Alleluia, alleluia, Franciscus, pauper tuis, celum vives in redentor, hymnis celestibus honorator, alleluia.
Mass this morning for the Feast of the Stigmata of St. Francis is being offered for Judy Phelps and her intentions. Our prayer for vocations, O God, we earnestly beseech thee to bless the Church with many priests, brothers, and sisters, who are worthy of their whole strength, be faithful to their vocation, and gladly strengthen our lives to teach thy truths, serve thy Church, and to make known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children. O Mary, Queen of the Clergy,
pray for us,
pray for our priests, our families, and religious. Obtain for us many more. Amen. The prayer to Our Lady of Perpetual Help in this time of pandemic. O Mother of Perpetual Help, grant that I may ever invoke thy powerful name, which is the safeguard of the living and the salvation of the dying. O pure Virgin Mary, let your name be henceforth ever on my lips. Whenever I call upon you by name, hasten to help me. When I speak your sacred name or even think of you, what consolation, confidence, what sweetness and emotion fill my soul. I thank God for having given you so sweet, powerful, and lovely a name for my good. Let my love for you prompt me ever to greet you as Mother of Perpetual Help. Maria Mater Ecclesiae et Bonum Fatime. Two reminders. Daily confessions are now held in church in the confessional from Monday through Saturday. And then on Sunday, we'll still go back to the porch for the time being until the weather begins to change. It's not going to the confessional that bothers me. It's all the people standing in line for confession, getting all too close to people sitting. I don't know how we're going to work that. We
on the epistle of Blessed Paul the Apostle to the Galatians. Brethren, but God forbid that I should glory, save in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom the world is crucified to me and I to the world. For in Christ Jesus neither circumcision availeth anything, nor uncircumcision, but a new creature. And whosoever shall follow this rule, peace on them and mercy, and upon the Israel of God. From henceforth let no man be troublesome to me, for I bear the marks of the Lord Jesus in my body. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with your spirit, brethren. Amen. A continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. At that time Jesus said to his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, and take up his cross, and follow me. For he that will save his life shall lose it, and he that shall lose his life for my sake shall find it. For what doth it profit a man if he gain the whole world and suffer the loss of his own soul? Or what exchange shall a man give for his soul? For the Son of Man shall come in the glory of his Father with his angels, and then will he render to every man according to his works. Thus far the words of the Holy Gospel.
Any idea of miracles that are described celebrates it, but it was a gift that God gave him of physical suffering to join with Christ. I don't think too many of us would want to beg for something like that. It wasn't a pleasant reality, but he received it as a witness. One of his confreres later on down the centuries, St. Pio Pietrelcina, received the stigmata. And people that in the modern world actually got to see them in his hands. So they couldn't doubt that these things could happen. It actually happened to him. And when it did happen, there was all types of commotion of trying to think, well, maybe this was made up, maybe he did this to himself. They questioned everything about it and actually almost silenced him for a while until it was proven that, yes, this is all legitimate. It really is. It does happen. So we have a modern example of it. And other saints throughout history have received, St. Rita, the thorn in her head. Other saints have received all types of these things, which we in the modern world think are just fables and fantasies, but they're not. They happen. The church proclaims them. The third thing is that we talk about the saint on that day. St. Francis was a man who gave up everything of this world to serve God. He did it in a much more dramatic way than any of us ever could think of doing. But his idea was to point his followers to live like Christ did, as close as possible. How did Christ live? He wasn't married. How did Christ live? He went from house to house and received his nourishment. So that the friars begged for their food and their sustenance. They wore one robe of a coarse, a gray or brown robe that they wore, a rope around their waist. They lived a very simple, simple life, sleeping on the floor, walking in bare feet many times. So these things were ways that they tried to conform themselves to Christ and renounce this world, and so that very life itself was a suffering, and yet they received great joy from it. And St. Francis would take it, God would give them one gift further to show his love for him and as an example to all of us. And finally, we today think of the great virtues that are spoken about, in the wisdom, in the gospel, and the introit, that, to my glory in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, we all have sufferings, we all have pains, we all have problems, we all have difficulties, none of us is exempt. We all wish we could have everything going right, but it doesn't. And so therefore, we have to unite those things with the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. We may not have received the stigmata to suffer, maybe we receive some other type of suffering. And our tendency is to complain and moan about it and feel sorry for ourselves. But we have to push through that. And we have to give it over to our Lord and say, I glory in nothing but the cross of my Lord Jesus Christ. In him is my salvation and my redemption. And so it teaches us at least like this to keep going, to never stop, to never give up, to continue to beg God's mercy and fight through it and ask that this suffering, this thorn, this pain be something that purifies us of our sins, purifies us of our weaknesses, and makes us stronger and more loving of God and more appreciative of all the good he gives us, and not to complain and moan and groan. So these are good things, and yet we have to be taught them over and over again in our lives, because we're human and we're damaged by original sin. And I often think, when I think of God's mercy, I think, how his mercy has to be so great we can't imagine, because how can he put up with us day, after year after year, after decade after decade, and we're still complaining or falling in the same things? And I know my patience would have been worn thin with me a long time ago. And yet his isn't. That itself is one of the greatest miracles we could ever believe in and accept. So this is a beautiful feast day to remind us of all those things. And we ask St. Francis of Assisi to pray for us.
Vobis, whom never
quite
remembers. Veritas mea, misericordia mea commixo, et in nomine Deo, exultabitur corum eius. sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et nos inducas in tentationem,
sed liberi nos de todo mal.
Eronia secula secula.
Amen.
Pax Domini, sit semper vobiscum.
Et in cui spiritu tuo.
Agnus Dei, cruxulis peccata mundi,
miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei, cruxulis peccata mundi,
miserere nobis.
Agnus Dei, cruxulis peccata mundi,
dona nobis pacem.
Domine nostrum Dei. Domine nostrum Dei. Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui toli peccato mundi.
Domine nostrum Deus, qui intercessus peccatum meum,
sanctus in verbo et sanctus per anima mea.
Domine nostrum Deus, qui intercessus peccatum meum,
sanctus in verbo et sanctus per anima mea.
Domine nostrum Deus, qui intercessus peccatum meum,
sanctus in verbo et sanctus per anima mea.
Thank you.
Fidelis Servus et Prudens, per constituit Dominus superfamiliam suam, ut detenis in tempore critici mensura. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Deus qui mira crucis mysteria, in Beato Francisco, confessore tuo, multiformiter demonstrasti, da nobis quesumus devotionis suae semper exempla sectari, et assidua eustem crucis meditatione muneri et muniri, per Domino nostro, Jesu, Christum filium tuum, videco libera prima, et unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum. Ite missa est. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Dominus vobiscum. Initium sancti evangelii sanctorum. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat verbum. Huc erat in principio apud Deum, omni ad erixum fata sunt et sine ipso factum est nihil, quod factum est. In ipso vita erat, et vita erat ut sumum, et lux in tenebris lucet, et tenebre heo non comprehendere. Ui homo missus ad Deo, ui nomen erat Ioannes, ut venit in testimonium, ut testimonium periberet in lumine, ut omnes credere. Non erat in luce ut testimonium per libere in lumine. Erat lux vera, quae illuminat omnem hominem venientem in hoc mundum. In mundo erat, et mundus per ipsum factus est, et mundus eo non cognovit. In proprio venit, et sui eo non receperent. Quod quod datum receperent eum dei Deis potestatem filios Dei fieri, isqui credunt in nomine eos, in non ex sanguinibus, neque ex voluntate carnis, neque ex voluntate viris sed ex Deo natus sum. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother
of God,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Hail
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee, the power for thy children of need. To thee, who has sent up our sighs, the wounded and weakling in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us. Then, after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O Clement, O Loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, the Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. O God, our refuge and our strength, look down with favor upon thy people who cry to thee, and through the intercession of the glorious and immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, of blessed Joseph, her spouse, of thy blessed apostles, Peter, Paul, and all the saints, do thou mercifully and graciously hear the prayers which we pour forth for the conversion of sinners, and for the freedom and exaltation of Holy Mother Church in the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him on whom we pray, and do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who crowd about the world seeking the ruined souls. Amen.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Saint Joseph, Saint Francis,
pray for us.
says finish. See that?